pictures, concrete barricades, barbed wire, and camouflage masked warriors facing off with blue soldiers armed with rifles and tear gas. Sirens are screeching. People are screaming. Even the very air is filled with gas. Welcome, judges, teachers, parents, and fellow students. I am here to tell you why the Oakland crisis photo standoff at Oakland changed Canada the most. From the dramatic showdown, to the emotional in-depth photo, to the devastating aftermath. In the spring of 1989, the Mohawks went to the town of Oakland, loudly protesting the expropriation of the Native burial grounds. The Oakland golf course wanted to expand from 9 holes to 18, and they didn't care whether the Mohawks protested or not. Even the mayor agreed. The Mohawks had no allies. On April 29th, frustrated with diplomatic negotiations, the Mohawks set up concrete barricades and barbed wire around the area that the golf course wanted. The message clear, they didn't want any intruders. The government's response was unnecessarily violent, and several people were aghast at what happened next. The police force, armed with rifles and tear gas, stormed the barricades. And one of the police force, muscle men, lay dead. The police retreated due to the wind blowing the tear gas right back at them. This seemed to be the most violent it would get, but no. Soon the army was coming in with tanks. It is evident that the Oka crisis is a traumatic event that affected both the Mohawk community and the government forever. There are many reasons why the photo standoff at Oka is so powerful. It's a scene of two soldiers staring each other down. On the left, Brad Rook, staring down at Patrick with enough menace in his looks to kill. On the right, Patrick Cloutier, staring at Brad with enough determination in his looks to kill him. Without a doubt, the Oka photo changed Canada the most. For example, the website worldfamousphotos.com voted this photo the best and most well-known in all of Canada. This photo represents a crisis that was the most famous ever. It was so well-known that other Native tribes helped this one tribe however they could. It included shipment of concrete barricades, barbed wire, and even arms. Afterwards, this crisis was so devastating that the government had to make rules that would help Natives get and keep the rightful land. When I first gazed upon this awe-inspiring photo, I noticed the anger and determination etched into the faces of the two soldiers as they stared upon one another. But then, as I read my research, I realized that this photo represented much more. It represented every single struggle between the Natives and the government. Brad represents the First Nations people, determined to beat the Canadians or the government again and again, as they have for so long. Patrick represents Canada or the government, angry that First Nations people are pushing them around and determined to win this time by any means necessary. From the dramatic showdown, to the emotional in-depth photo, to the devastating aftermath, the photo standoff at Oka changed Canada the most. Thank you.